Hello, this is Linda Vetrus Nichols, and I have the most amazing woman with me, Jennifer Beats. Welcome, Jennifer.
Hi, Linda. Happy to be here with you today.
So great to have you. Love yourself. Oh, yeah. It took me a long time before I even realized that I wasn't loving myself, right? Getting through actually a 33-year starter marriage with two kids. And when I did come together with my now husband, Terry Earthwind Nichols, I thought I had like arrived at loving myself, and I hadn't. So I had even more inner work to do. So what do you have to say about love yourself, Jennifer?
Thank you, Linda. This is a great question. I recognized through my whole transformation that I was so busy loving everyone else that I forgot about myself. Mm. And yeah. Being a mother, and at the time I was in a marriage that, being a wife and also working, I was being pulled in different directions and I wasn't paying attention to the directions.
Okay.
I was just going where I was going.
Yep.
And I was living in a stressful environment. We're all constantly around change. And it wasn't until I got off of that roller coaster, if you will,
okay,
and started to get quiet. And the way that I chose to do that is through a meditation practice.
Okay.
And the more quiet I became, the more I heard myself. And the more I heard myself, the more I recognized how I wasn't meeting my own needs.
Okay.
And actually, Linda, I was expecting other people to meet my needs.
And so you were meeting everybody else's, so they might as well meet yours, right?
Right. However, what I also wasn't doing is I wasn't expressing myself in a way that others could meet those needs for me.
Mm-hmm. Good point.
Mm-hmm. It was through my own self-discovery of recognizing that I can fill up my own cup.
Mm-hmm. I
can care for myself.
Mm, absolutely.
I can recognize what my needs are, and then I can take action to fill those needs. And when I started to do that, my whole world started to expand.
I started
to feel this abundance.
Right.
For life and for love and for myself.
Mm-hmm. Total compassion for self for a change, right? Because you're a very compassionate person. So you had that one, but when it came to yourself, not so much, right?
Right. It was a gift to turn it on myself. Mm-hmm. And to learn how to let go of the negative way that I was talking to myself.
Right.
And embrace the positive and loving, caring, like you said, Linda, compassionate ways.
Yeah.
To speak to ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And the more I started to pour on the love to myself,
mm-hmm,
not only did I feel loved, I could give love away to others without feeling resentful, without guilt, without any shame. I started to turn that compassion towards myself. And the more I started to fill up my own cup, the more that I could give away love to others without depleting my own energy and my own love for myself.
That's so great. It's so important.
Right. It was a big change from who I used to be. I used to freely give to everyone else and not myself.
Okay.
And now I've turned that around where I give to myself so that mm-hmm I can freely give to others.
Woo-woo. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so love yourself. It's about connect, right? Connect with like yourself initially, right? So that you can be grounded and filled and have enough in your cup that you're actually overflowing, right? So you can have the compassion and be able to feel even like connecting with others, right?
Right. And I feel that a lot of times we don't really get those messages. A lot of times we are told to, or maybe some of the messages that I received was to look after others first.
Mm-hmm.
And I certainly, for a female, I have people pleasing tendencies. And so there is a balancing act to giving to others and giving to yourself.
Right.
And I think I had it backwards for a while. And I was feeling depleted.
Yeah.
And now I recognize, I feel like I was saying, I feel an abundance of love. And it all started with how I was treating myself.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. Okay, so when it comes to love yourself and all knowledge is within, what was some of that knowledge that you were able to tap into that you realized were inside? You know, I'm just real quick, in The Wizard of Oz, the yellow brick road is in the shape of the antispiral, and the antispiral looks like kind of like a letter C in the center, kind of depending on when you turn it, but you can get it to look like a letter C. And it's the oldest, most ancient peace symbol in the world, is my understanding. And it actually, in Native America, it means the coming together of the people of Mother Earth. So it's like the going in, not the going out. The spiral was used to, you know, put on a tree or under a rock, and the end of it was like, we went that away, you know, so the hunters or the warriors would go look for the spiral and know which direction the tribe left in. The antispiral is the going in. And I just think it's so cool that it's an antispiral, the yellow brick road, you know, and it's like, Dorothy, you know, you knew it all along, right? Isn't that fun? Yeah.
Yes.
So how about your little antispiral journey, like Dorothy?
Right. Right. And I think for me, Linda, it ties into that people pleasing too. And for me, I was constantly adapting to meet other people's needs.
Right.
And not recognizing my worth,
mm-hmm.
not recognizing my value, mm-hmm. therefore looking outside for that validation and that
right.
acceptance, until the light went on for me. And as I was saying earlier, as I started to fill up my own cup and turn that self-love and that self-care on myself,
yeah.
all of a sudden my answers started to bubble up.
Mm.
All of a sudden, my voice would speak words that never used to come out of me. And so I just found through my journey that it wasn't about going outside and looking for the answers. It was actually about slowing down,
mm-hmm.
pausing long enough to reflect.
Mm.
And it is yeah. through that reflective process that I started to hear my voice, and my voice became my guide.
Mm-hmm.
And I started to trust build trust with myself. And all of a sudden my intuition was leading me and guiding me, and I started to listen to it.
Nice.
And I started to take steps I had never taken before.
Mm-hmm.
And I think a big part of that is because of all the noise that was going on in my mind.
Right.
I think for all of us, our intuition is constantly giving us reminders,
mm-hmm.
and it's up to us if we choose to listen to those.
I love it. Brilliant. And you are really good at, like, with the inflection in your voice, not just your words, but I've noticed you put an extra emphasis, almost an energy, into like your decisions. Or like, I remember you were talking about maybe orange for your logo, and then it was like, you know, you were very firm that it was the purple. So mm-hmm. like you had said in the past, you didn't really let people know. Well, I've noticed that you're letting people know with even this extra, I don't know if it's a force or a push of energy, power, really, you know, power versus force. Like,
yeah.
Emphasis to get it across, like, this is it, and this is what I like, and this is what I'm doing, without being obnoxious about it. I just know that there's this little extra oomph that a lot of times women don't bother to do. Does that make sense?
It does, Linda. As you were saying that, right away I was taken back to being a child. Mm-hmm. and having the women in my life second guess my intuition.
Ah.
And because they second guessed it, so did I.
Sure.
And yeah. So and I've always had that intuitive superpower, and I see it in my son. My son was 7 years old, and he was trying to tell us something intuitively about an upcoming storm, and we didn't want to hear. No, you're too young. We dismissed him.
Ooh.
That storm came, and boy, did we all get hurt, actually. We were on a beach, and out of nowhere came this really nasty storm with hail. And we all went running, and we all got pelted with the hail. It was actually many of us fell as we were running up steps. It was very chaotic. So just a little snippet there. But after that, I started to recognize, hey, wait a minute. What is it about the younger children that we dismiss their intuition? Right. Or at least right. I did. And so, yes, Linda, what you're talking about just brings me back to being that little girl and having others question my intuition. Wow. Now I'm at a point in my life where I trust myself and my yep. intuition. And I think that's what you hear from me now.
I love it. Thank mm-hmm. you so much, Jennifer.
You're welcome.